that one too small. Good day, bud. This is a ruffed grouse, I think. It might be a sooty. I'm actually not confident. Hey, bird. A lot of folks will just pop the breasts out, which I think is getting probably just half of the meat. I definitely think it's worth taking the whole animal home. Especially the livers and the hearts of these guys are surprisingly delicious. That was the first snack I eat. And I used to always dress everything in the field, but now that I have chickens, I like to bring the entrails home for them to eat. So, great. Got some game. So, butchering a grouse is super easy. You can either do this out in the field if you want to sort of keep the fuss and feathers and mess out there. It's also fine to do it at home like I'm going to. Like I said, I like to bring the entrails home for my chickens to eat, so the cleanest way for me to do that is just to keep them in the bird. There's a little bit more, for whatever reason, of a tradition of aging birds with their guts in. I couldn't really tell you why that's done, but it is common practice, I think, especially if you listen to sort of the old ways of doing it in Europe. So that's a little bit different from like a deer or a big game animal where there's some urgency to getting the guts out of the body as quickly as you can so it'll cool down and limit bacteria intruding into your meat. So you can see I just sort of clipped off all the extremities. There's no meat at all on the last joint of the wing, and hardly anything on the joint before that. So those go, and then you know the feet can go. From there, you can use a knife, or honestly, you don't even need to. Their skin is so fragile, you can just sort of tear them open. For wild birds, almost all the time, I am skinning them rather than plucking them. I do love, chicken skin and skin on wild birds, but gosh, it multiplies the effort for what you get, so I don't think it's worth doing a lot of the time. So it's just, I'm just pulling it right apart with my hands. You don't need to use a knife at all, just kind of undressing it. You can see where I shot him. This was a .22 bullet, I think it was a 23 grain copper. So, since the bullet's non-toxic, you don't have to worry about lead around the wound channel, which is nice. We'll probably end up going in there and cleaning out any bone fragments or anything. That's it. Sits outside of the breast. This is where the bird will eat a piece of food, and then it will sit in its crop, and then the crop will ration the food out to the gizzard, which lies inside of the body cavity. So here's the crop. If you do pluck a bird, you want to make sure and leave the skin on. You want to make sure to take the crop out. And let's see. I'm just curious what it was eating. So these are needles. Yeah. These are some sort of fur needle, I guess. This is just so easy. It really just takes a couple minutes. So this starts to look more and more like a rotisserie chicken in the store. And basically, anything that you would do with chicken, you can probably do with grouse. The one thing, when you twisting a little to pull the tail right off, I always feel bad throwing these away, they're so beautiful. The one thing to bear in mind when you skin them like this is that you lose that layer of like moisture barrier and fat that comes with the skin. And so that can make them a little bit sensitive to dry roasting. You're liable to dry out the meat if you cook them like that. But otherwise, you can do virtually anything with a skinned grouse. You can pot roast it. You could put in a casserole. And it's got a really sort of delicate flavored meat, I guess you could say. Bland is another word. So if you add salt, that helps, and it will really readily take up the flavor of whatever you cook it in. So garlic or whatever seasonings you like. Alright, so that we'll wash them off when it's all done, but that takes care of the skin and feathers for the most part. I'm not going to make you watch while I clean off every last one of them. And now I like to gut them after doing that. Of course, you could gut them at any time, but I can see what I'm doing a little bit better when the feathers are gone. So, here's where the tail was, here's the cloaca. I'm gonna cut on either side of that. Try not to puncture the intestines. Of course, depending on how you shoot the bird, if you take it with a shotgun, you may well have shot through the body cavity and you know, tearing up the organs. In that case, I would suggest gutting it as quickly as possible. Even though still in some places they would not. I'm told that pheasants shot at estates in England will just be hung, whole bird, regardless of how it was shot. So you can reach your fingers in a little bit right here. I'm squeezing on, I think it's the gizzard, which will sort of, it's like a nice firm organ. It's not going to rupture. And you can sort of squeeze everything out with it. Here's the gizzard. And like I was saying, here's some, there's some fir needles that were being fed into it right here from the crop. So, keep this for the chickens. Put it on this plate for now. Gingerly get all those intestines out. Alright. Here's the liver. I could give this to my hens, but I'm going to keep this for myself. I love to just put a dab of oil in a frying pan and some salt and just fry that up as a little snack. Super healthy to eat livers, and they're really tasty out of birds, I find. Likewise, here's the heart. I will fry that up alongside the liver. It's just got like a little bit of gristle on top, so cut that off, give it to my hens. And then your bird's pretty well clean. Now I'm just gonna rinse it off and, you know, cook it like anything. Make sure I get the wound channel here cleaned up. I'm not really feeling any bone shards. It looks like bullet hit kind of here, sort of grazed the spine, which I'm guessing is why it dropped so quickly, and then went right out the front. So there's no metal in the bird. I'm not really finding bone flex. So that was a pretty clean hit, just like right at the base of the neck. It's a good shot. So I'll rinse them off, and okay, and that's pretty much your bird. It's just like a little chicken. Quite a bit of the meat is on the breasts. The thighs also have a good amount. A little bit on the wings for these guys, and then there's sort of just bits here and there, just tucked into the carcass.